Ryzen 5000 series is just around the corner, so it's time to check out another B550 board. This time I have MSI B550M Bazooka. It's more of a budget and one of the best value-oriented MATX motherboards that provide excellent VRM performance. You can use it with Ryzen 5 or even Ryzen 9 CPUs, as it can handle any of these. So if you are up for building a smaller AMD-based system, this board might be for you. But if this is your first time on this channel, on Epic Game Tech I share my passion in gaming PC build videos, unboxing parts and helping you guys by posting simple how-to guides. So if you find these topics interesting, consider subscribing. Alright, so many of us are waiting for Zen3 to be released in a week or so. And probably you are wondering what kind of motherboard you should get for Ryzen 5000. B550 is a good pick not only for an upcoming CPU lineup, but it's also a good choice for Ryzen 3000 build as well. Previously I did an overview of an ATX board, ASRock B550 Extreme 4. It's a really good motherboard for any Ryzen processor, especially if you're planning to overclock it. So in case you want to check it out, I will leave a link at the top right corner. Let's get back to MSI B550M Bazooka. I will do a quick unboxing, walk through its features and motherboard's I/O. At first, let's have a look at what accessories are included in the box. An MSI sticker. Basically, it can boost your performance by a few percent. Use it at your own risk. A disk with drivers and utilities. Probably you will do it anyway, but I want to be sure. Guys, please download the latest drivers from an official website instead of using this one. Some ad material to show off some of the MSI's products and the loyalty program they run. One of the best friends when assembling a PC, board's manual, especially when plugging PC case front I/O connectors. Additionally, there is an included quick guide with quite clear CPU installation details. B550M Bazooka comes with two included SATA cables for your SSD or a hard drive, a few included M.2 screws, and an I/O shield. The motherboard itself is nothing fancy, but it has quite a few nice heatsinks, including M.2 shield. So it's a bit of an aggressive gamer-ish but neutral color looks, and it will definitely fit most of a PC build themes. Moving forward, let's go through the main features this motherboard can offer. First of all, as for its price, Bazooka has quite a performing VRM with beefy heatsinks, and so this board can handle any Ryzen CPU at stock speed. With a decent airflow, it can handle even an overclocked 3900X with no probs. There are a few M.2 slots, one of which is covered with a nice shield and supports currently the fastest Gen 4 M.2 drives. I'm not yet convinced anyone needs those crazy expensive SSDs, but still you will have this feature in case you need it someday. Regarding USB headers, the board features one USB 3.2 Gen 1 and a few USB 2.0 headers. But that's not all, USB Type-C internal header is found only on a few micro ATX motherboards, so this is a nice feature to get. In case you decide to get some RGB fans or LED strips, this motherboard has two RGB and two addressable RGB headers. And speaking of fans, it features CPU, pump and three additional fan headers. We will get into an I/O soon, but I need to mention a flash BIOS button feature. It's always handy for an easier BIOS update process. Moving forward, let's have a look at motherboard's I/O. Connection-wise, it's quite a standard one if compared to the same budget motherboards. We have a BIOS flash button I mentioned previously, a display and HDMI 2.1 ports in case you decide to use a CPU with integrated graphics, 4 third-gen USB Type-A ports, then a PS2 port, 2 second-gen USB Type-A ports, a gigabit LAN, and 7.1 digital audio. MSI B550M Bazooka sells for around $130. It's one of the best choices in case you want to get a good budget micro ATX board and plan to overclock your Ryzen CPU. Even if you get Bazooka for a Ryzen 5 today, you can be sure it will handle Ryzen 9 when you decide to upgrade later on. Just be sure to take into consideration if you'll need Wi-Fi, since this board does not have one. Also, it's a micro ATX motherboard, so if you wish to build in ATX PC case, you should consider ATX motherboard as well. But as always, I will share a few more MATX recommendations for lower and higher budget. Let's start with a low budget recommendation. Honestly, the cheapest and still decent motherboard I would recommend is ASRock B550M Pro 4. It's around $105 and would pair well with Ryzen 5 or even Ryzen 7 processors. However, in case you're planning to go for Ryzen 9 CPU and overclock it, I would suggest looking into MSI B550M motor. Design-wise, it's very similar to B550 Bazooka, pretty much the same style, but this board features a better VRM and so you can overclock your Ryzen 5 CPU with no issues. Also, you get faster 2.5 gigabit LAN, better audio and a USB Type-C port. And it's around $160 US, or $170 for a Wi-Fi version. For an ATX form factor B550 recommendation, you can get MSI B550A Pro motherboard. It's around $10 or $15 more than a Bazooka. But A Pro has a better VRM, so you could potentially overclock Ryzen 9 3950X. Feature-wise, both boards are pretty much the same. And as always, I will leave links to all of these B550 motherboards in the description below. In case you have any questions or doubts regarding any board, just leave a comment and I will get back to you guys. I hope you enjoyed B550 Bazooka overview, and you can find even more stunning videos by clicking here.